Hi everyone. In this section, we'll see about gating system in casting. So in the earlier sections, we have seen about what is a casting and what are the steps involved in casting and what are patterns and what are the patterns made up of and what are different types of patterns. Now we'll say about gating system. So this gating system is used for the smooth flow of molten metal into the metal cavity without any voids, solid inclusions or air bubbles, right? So there should be a uniform flow of molten metal into the cavity so that only the final output of the casting component will be perfect without any inclusions or voids or turbulence. Turbulence in this, it's a air. So for that we need a gating system. So there will be four parameters why we have to use this gating system. First one is for the clean flow of molten metal into the cavity. So molten metal should be clean without any dust particles, right? Next one is uniform flow. There should be a uniform flow of molten metal into the cavity, or else there will be a chance of bulk turbulence. Turbulence is, as I said, it is a air. So if the flow is not uniform and irregular, if there is an irregular flow of molten metal, there will be a chance of turbulence forming inside the cavity. That means there will be air bubbles, which leads to poor quality in terms of wear and tear of the casting component. Next one is smooth flow of molten metal, and the flow should be smooth without any up and downs. So this is possible with the help of gating system. Next one is complete flow of molten metal, and the flow of molten metal should be complete, or it should be completely filled inside the cavity. So these are the four parameters that are used for the gating system, right? So we'll see what are the components involved in this gating system. We shall take a simple casting process. This is called as a sand casting process. This is called as a pouring cup. First one is pouring cup. It is used for the flow of molten metal from the ladle. We call as LADLE, ladle. Ladle in the sense, it is a scoop like thing. So by using a scoop, we used to pour that molten metal into this through the pouring cup. This is a This is called as a pouring cup. Right? Next one is down sprue, or just called as a sprue. So it is a circular like component which wherein the molten metal from the pouring cup will pass down from the pouring cup. It will come to the area which is circular in shape. It is called as a sprue. Since the flow is down, we call as a down sprue, or else you just call as a sprue. Right? By using atmospheric pressure as well as gravity, if you pour that molten metal through the pouring cup, it enters through the circular component called as a down sprue. Right? Next. From the down sprue, this area is called as a sprue well. So what is this purpose of this sprue well? It converts direction of molten metal from one angle to other angle. So if you see, the molten metal will be from top to bottom like this here. When it comes to here, it becomes horizontal. So at this sprue well, the molten metal will take a direction or change in direction with respect to flow. So that is the purpose of sprue well. Next one is runner. So this area is called as a runner. So the molten metal will pass from this sprue well through the runner. Runner is nothing but a passage, flow in one direction. It is called as a runner. Through the runner, it comes to the ingate. This is called the ingate. So before runner and ingate, there is a component called slag trap. In other words, we call as a filter. So this filter, it is the last stage where the molten metal is going to enter into the ingate. So this slag trap filters all the impurities that is available in the molten metal, so that the molten metal inside the cavity or entering into the cavity will be free of dust particles. Right? So this is the metal cavity. Right? So these are the 5 stages or 5 steps involved in a gating system. And this is called as a drag. This line we call as a parting line. This area is called as a cope. And this is a flask. and this is called as a mold, all these things, and this is called as a riser. We'll see about the riser. So parting lines is the separation between first half of the casting component and second half of the casting component. So it is a line which separates the upper portion of the casting and the lower portion of the casting. So the upper portion of the mold or the parting line we call as a hope, and the lower portion we call as a drag. So all this area we call as a drag, on complete area we call as a hope, and this is called as a core. This is called as a core. So these are the components available in the gating system. And there are different types of gating system based on the parting line. There are different types of gating system available based on the parting line. First one is horizontal gating system. So this horizontal gating system, as the name indicates, ingate will be horizontal, or the flow of metal will be horizontal direction. The flow will be in horizontal, and here is the ingate and here will be the casting part. If you take the example of the sand casting, it is a horizontal gating system. See, the flow of metal will, molten metal is in horizontal direction and ingate is in the horizontal direction. So molten metal will flow in horizontal direction for entering into the mold cavity. Right? So this is a horizontal gating system, and it is used for ferrous metals. And it is not used for non-ferrous metals. Ferrous metals will be steel, mild steel, next cast iron, but okay, because the strength involved in the ferrous metals will be high compared to the non-ferrous metals. So that is why we use horizontal gating system for ferrous metals. So mostly we use only horizontal, most of the cases. Next one is vertical gating system. So this is used for vertical castings, vertical casting pipes. It is used for manufacturing vertical casting pipes, wherein the flow will be uniform and the pressure will be built. If you enter molten metal from the bottom, there will be some set of pressure built inside it, and the casting will be strong enough, or the tube that is manufactured through the vertical gating system will be hardened. So to explain you here, just I will modify it. Just I'm explaining you about the schematic representation. So molten metal enters like this, because it is entering from the bottom. Ingate will be bottom of the mold cavity, right? This is just to explain about the concept, right? So this is about the vertical gating system. Bottom gating system. This is similar to the vertical one. So vertical in sense, it can come like this, or from the top. It can be from the top also. This gating system can be from the top. So this is also called as a vertical. Bottom gating system. It is similar to the vertical gating system, wherein the ingate will be bottom, only at the bottom, and the flow will be from the bottom. But wherein vertical means it can be bottom or it can be from the top. We can go either of it. But whereas in bottom gating system, the flow will be from the bottom only. Right? This is also used for casting tubes. Next one, middle gating. So it can be vertical or it can be bottom. That means it is in the middle of the gating system. Molten metal flows from the middle of the component. The ingate will be in the mid of the casting cavity, mold cavity, right? So these are the different types of gating systems in casting. So now, what is the purpose of riser? Riser contains molten metal. Why there is a riser here? Riser is nothing but a circular component, circular path arranged between mold cavity and the passage, or before the mold cavity. Why? Because during solidification process or during cooling process of this casting or mold cavity, there will be some bubbles or air. So in order to feel that, the molten metal from the riser enters into the mold cavity during solidification process for uniform mold, to get the uniform casting. So this riser will be placed before the mold cavity. It will be in the circular because pressure will be more. And there are two types of risers here. One is open riser and other is closed riser. Open riser, molten metal flows through atmospheric pressure as well as the gravitational pressure. In this open riser, molten metal flows through the mold cavity by atmospheric pressure as well as the gravity. नेक्स्ट वन इज क्लोज्ड राइजर और वी कॉल एज अ ब्लाइंडर राइजर. इन दिस द मोल्टन मेटल फ्लोस ओनली थ्रू ग्रेविटी, ग्रेविटेशनल प्रेशर. मोल्टन मेटल पासेस थ्रू द mold cavity by using only gravitational pressure because there is no atmospheric pressure since it is closed, right? So this is used for uniform filling of the mold cavity during solidification process. So solidification process in this, it is the state wherein the liquid molten metal is cooled and converted into a solid state, which we call as a casting in this case. So this is called as a solidification process, right? So this is about the gating system and different components in gating system, and why do we use this gating system and different types of gating system, and we have seen about the purpose of riser and types of riser. Please. Thank you.